Okay, you guys, so this is going to be the first time that I'm leaving the house to actually sit in a cafe and work and to look at one of the shops that I've been waiting to get into since the lockdown. For those of you who don't know, we have been in lockdown here in Sydney since the 24th of June and have just been released yesterday, the 11th of October. I'm still quite feeling a bit awkward about this whole thing, but I'll see how well I can re-acclimatize to the situation. Just a quick OOTD, this is a Tommy Hilfiger knit secondhand, Levi's chino secondhand. That's my Converse high tops. And I'll be bringing my Dior Motion backpack with me because that's going to be where my work laptop is. I've got a webinar from 11:30 till 2 o'clock. So I'll be sitting at a cafe, hopefully, if they are going to allow us now. And work from there. And then I'll probably do a quick visit to Saint Laurent. It's raining. It's a very rainy day today in Sydney. Yeah, I'll see you all again when I'm sitting at a cafe. Okay, so you guys, I'm currently sitting here at Max Brenner. I ordered a few things. Let me just show you. So, working. Savory pretzel, strawberry milkshake. And over there, we'll be having an unboxing today, I guess. So I guess I just want to talk you through my experience after coming out of lockdown today. There still wasn't a lot of people out and about in the city, but I think that's to be expected. A lot of people are still working from home, so the city is not as busy as it normally would be. The shopping center has got quite a few people, actually. But here at Max Brenner, there's only myself and one other customer, and it's lunchtime, so that's kind of surprising. but in a good way, I guess. So I've had to check in with a QR code and also show my vaccination certificate that I've been fully vaccinated, because only those who have been double vaccinated are actually allowed to be out and about. So luckily I had that done early on in April. So now it's just really a matter of staying on and doing some work right now here at the cafe. It's the first time in since June 2024 that I've actually been out and sat anywhere. So yeah. All right, I'm gonna have my quick lunch and I'm gonna keep working. So I am back home and we're gonna do an unboxing. If you have followed me on this channel, sorry, I don't have any makeup on. I just like quickly went to the shop and came back after I've had my pretzel, okay? So just excuse the bare face. Anyway, so this is the first time I've ever bought anything brand new from a designer shop. It was quite daunting, to be honest, especially when you hear about how some places are quite snobby, especially like the sales associates. They're like, look at you head to toe if you're not properly dressed or whatever. So I was a little bit anxious, but I was already like texting my SA. She's not really my essay because I've only met her today, but I made an inquiry online and she was the one who responded to me. So I wanted to make sure that she was the one that I was going to be talking to and buying from, because she was so nice and lovely. I just have to say that the Saint Laurent staff at the Westfield Sydney shop were really, really nice. From the security person all the way to the SAs, they were very, very nice, very, very accommodating. They asked me to show that I've checked in with my QR code. They've asked me to show that I have been fully vaccinated. And after that, it was like they couldn't offer me anything to drink in the store because of the COVID restrictions that are still in place, but they did give me to take away a bottle of Aquapana, which if you're familiar with fancy waters, that's probably one of the fanciest ones. So I did take that with me because I spent a lot of money, so I at least get water, right? Anyways, like I said, if you have been watching me before, then you would know what is going to be in this. Okay, so they gave me this paper bag. It's very sturdy, and in that paper bag is the box. Nigara, who's my SA, gave me, well, this one is the receipt, and this one is her business card. Okay, and you'll see that there's a ribbon that holds the box together, and it's really nicely tied. I do have one other thing in here, which I bought from Mecca Cosmetica because I've run out, and it is my Origins Drink Up Intensive. Those of you who know me in real life would know that I swear by this because it's the only thing that quenches my dehydrated skin. Anyways, enough about that. Let's unbox this thing. So I'm just gonna try and slide it. Able to slide that off, and then it's just a very flat box, so you'll probably tell what it is. You open it up and it's in a tissue, and what I'm gonna do, I'm just gonna slide that out of the tissue. Ooh. Care booklet, silica gel. Right. Okay, and then it came with this dust bag, and as you can see from the size of the dust bag, this is not the Uptown pouch, although I really was tempted to buy both, but I didn't want to spend that much money. So here it is. Yes, it is the YSL monogram clutch in the vintage Blanc color with gold hardware. Like, how beautiful is that? right? I was actually contemplating on getting the dark beige color, just because I've got the Tory Burch in white that's coming. But I also thought I do already have a lot of like warmer beige colors, so I wanted something that's a little paler, I guess. So when I take this off and you just really slide it off, it comes with this wristlet that is detachable. I'm sure you've seen a lot of reviews about this anyways. It's detachable, right? And I've seen some people actually convert this into a shoulder bag by attaching a chain, right? So as I was saying, I have this dinky chain from Coach, but as you can probably see, the lobster claw is quite tiny. So if I wanted to make this into a crossbody bag, I probably will have to remove this wristlet and connect the two lobster claws of this Coach one on the pouch. Bring that over on that side and then carry it like so. You can see, so crossbody, it's right at my waist, and this is the shoulder. So that's actually not bad. I could totally do that. And the way this chain is designed doesn't look like it's gonna damage the leather because it's very rounded and smooth. Let me just show you. So that's what the chain looks like. There's no nothing that would scratch the leather. Okay, so the other way that Mel in Melbourne spoke about was to keep the wristlet here and tie or clasp the holder here, but since my lobster claw is very small, it's not gonna fit. So I'm likely going to just do the other one. I was a little bit scared actually that maybe the chain would come up a little bit too short if I did that, but it actually is fine. Right, now I'm going to show you what fits in here. So I've got my essentials in here. That's my wallet. There was a tissue paper in there. And there's a, by the way, so this is what it looks like. I should show you this, right? Inside is lined with black fabric. There is a slip pocket here. It's very tight though. You could put in maybe your cards in there. I actually don't need to bring this wallet because all of my cards are connected to my phone. The only thing that I would need to bring in here are my medical cards. So, but I'm still gonna show you, okay? So what's gonna fit in there? I've got my hand sanitizer, hand cream, because when you use hand sanitizer a lot, your hands dry up. A comb, small comb, my AirPods, pack of tissue, right. And then I can close that up. As you can see, it's a little bit bulky in here, but not too bad. There's no distortion, okay? So it looks fine to me. So it does pack a punch. It's not small. You can definitely carry all of your essentials. I don't typically put my phone in a bag anyway. It's usually in my pockets. But if I had to, I'll just take off the wallet, the card holder, take only the cards that I actually need and put my phone in here. But again, I usually have my phone in my hands, so there is really no need for me to have anything else, right? So, and this can be dressed up and dressed down according to however you want. So I'm pretty pleased with this purchase, and for a first time purchase in a designer luxury shop, it was a really good experience for me. So, Oh, and by the way, the price of this currently here in Australia is 970 Australian dollars, which sounds like a lot, I know, but for YSL, that's actually pretty good. And considering that you can carry everything that you need in here, I think that's a pretty good price. This is going to get used quite a lot, I feel like, especially now that we're coming into summer here in Australia. I feel like this is going to be my go-to, for the summer. There you go. I love it. I'm in love with it. I'm actually contemplating on getting a different color as well. Like, we'll see. Right. So thanks for watching. If you have any questions, let me know in the description, the comment section down below. Thanks for watching.